we just knew fundamentally drones are cool. That's the main reason that we got into it, the main reason why we were building drones in college. Verge Aero is a drone light show technology company. We fly swarms of hundreds of drones. They're like high-tech fireworks. We can dynamically build shapes in the sky and spell out logos, and we do this for some of the biggest names around the world.
What's the craziest one you've had to do?
The craziest one? Hey, Mason!
Yeah?
What's the craziest drone show that you've done so far?
Burning Man.
We had this thing that at the time we thought was this, you know, new idea. It generally was. We were thinking 25 drones doing all these cool shapes in the sky, like that's gonna blow people away. And then suddenly Intel puts out a video where they're doing 100. So we're all like, back to the drawing board.
We knew that we had to up our ante. We put on a bunch of demos, we went to investors, and we ended up raising some venture capital money. And that was enough for us to actually develop the core technology that we have today.
Don't film this. No. This is terrible. It's like using a crescent wrench on a bolt or something. It's like a big no-no.
Yeah, so this is one of the drones. The primary feature being this blindingly bright LED. And it's built to be super robust. It's got like a 3-to-1 power to weight ratio. It allows for flights in wind up to 20, gusting 30.
Most shows that we do are like 150 drones to 200 drones. That's like our standard show.
So tonight, we're going up to 600 that we'll have active at any one time, and I foresee no problems.
And the way that it works, I mean, we have 506 drones on the network right now. We're just going through one at a time at like... 100.
I worked with those students very, very closely. We saw the first efforts where they had a drone that we said, you've got to keep that thing tethered, okay? We don't trust it, we don't know if it's going to crash into something, to the point where we have now, where there's high confidence in the controllability of those drones.
Well, now I'm getting it.
But what about the ones that were still in the...
You're done? You're good?
I think so.
We certainly want to make sure that our students have the technical expertise in the subject matter that we teach them. But in today's field, it's really important that the students also have the entrepreneurial spirit, and this is something that we want to instill on them.
Next one, 80, right there.
What's been really inspiring is to see these three Rowan graduates build something completely from the ground up. It's not just about the engineering, it's also about the entrepreneurship and making it a business, making something that works.
It's really neat being able to see engineering in action and see how far Rowan graduates can come after graduating. So the different ways that you can go about exploring your own field and seeing all the different opportunities that you can create for yourself.
I really wanted to get into robotics, and it's really inspiring to see, like, wow, something that was just created came out of Rowan, not some Ivy League school.
So to be able to see that they have taken a concept that they were thinking and they built this literally from scratch, one drone at a time, is an immense point of pride for us, and it represents the best of what the program offers.
Without Rowan, I wouldn't have had the confidence to be able to build a company from scratch. I wouldn't have met Chris and Anthony. The technology between Verge Aero is us.
I found my passion for engineering here. I think a lot of schools where you're sitting in a lecture hall filled with hundreds of people and you're struggling to get lab time, and here I was able to, you know, just work as much as I wanted.
I think it goes back to the hands-on stuff. The clinic projects give exposure to real-world activities and not so much theoretical, and theory's great, but at the end of the day, the thing that builds companies is practical hands-on stuff.